Welcome to this session on refrigeration and air conditioning. We will continue with the numerical on Bell-Colburn cycle. This is type 3 numerical in which compression and expansion processes are polytropic. So we'll go through the question. A refrigerator unit working on Bell-Colburn cycle takes air from cold chamber at minus 10 degrees Celsius. So what is this minus 10 degrees Celsius? So cold chamber, we'll see the diagram. So cold chamber means it will be refrigerator part. So what is given over here? T1 temperature. So we'll write down the data. T1 temperature is 10 degrees Celsius. So 10 degrees Celsius, convert it to Kelvin. What is that? Minus 10. So minus 10 plus 273, 263 Kelvin. Next one. And the compresses it from 1 bar to 6.5 bar. So what is the initial pressure? So at point number 1, pressure is 1 bar. Compresses it from 1 bar. So point number 1, pressure is 1 bar. 1 bar to 6.5 bar. So point 2, pressure is 6.5 bar. So we'll write down the pressure values. So P1 is 100 kilopascal and P2 is 650 kilopascal. So we have converted bar into kilopascal. Next data which has been given is with index of compression being 1.2. So here you can see I have shown the schematic in which we have motor which is running the compressor. Then our parts in sequence will be, first one is compressor, then air cooler or heat exchanger, then expander, and last one is, this is not evaporator, it is refrigerator. So compressor will be from process 1 to 2 isentropic compression, then process 2 to 3 inside air cooler it will be constant pressure heat rejection, then 3 to 4 is isentropic expansion in expander, and 4 to 1 is constant pressure heat absorption in refrigerator. Now here what is this type of question? It is, here index has been given. Okay, so index of compression being 1.2, so it is not isentropic. So here the process of compression has been given as polytropic, and the index of this polytropic expansion has been given, L is 1.2. so here I have written for process 1 to 2, this is polytropic process, polytropic compression. So PV raised to index N is 1.2 equal to constant. Next data, the compressed air is cooled to a temperature 5 degree above the ambient temperature of 25 degree Celsius before it is expanded in expander when the index of expansion is 1.35. So here you can see process 3 to 4, this is polytropic expansion. Why? Because index has been given, index of expansion is 1.35. So PV raised to 1.35 is equal to constant. Now the compressed air, so means point number 2, compressed air, is cooled to a temperature 5 degree Celsius above ambient. So 5 degree Celsius above ambient, and ambient is how much? 25. So it will be 25 plus 5, 30. So it is cooled where? It is cooled in air cooler. So 0.3 temperature has been given. So 0.3 temperature, T3, is 30 degree Celsius. So T3 is 5 plus 25 equal to 30 degree Celsius. So 30 plus 273, 303 Kelvin. So in this case, I have drawn only PV diagram, and it is important to notice on the PV diagram that for compression, index is different, and for expansion, index is different. So we had derived there was a derivation of COP for polytropic process. If you recall, in that case, we had developed the equation of COP for polytropic process, but that was for compression as well as expansion having same index. Here index is different, so you cannot use that formula. So we have to go by the basics. So what will be the first step of solving this numerical? We have to calculate all the temperatures. Now temperature T1, it is given in question, and temperature T3 after the cooler, this temperature has been given in the question. So what we have to calculate? We have to calculate T2, and then we have to calculate T4. How we will calculate this process is which process? Polytropic. So we'll use relation between temperature and pressure. Calculate all the temperatures. So calculation of temperatures. So first temperature, we will calculate temperature T2. So how to write the formula of this temperature T2? This is which process? 1 to 2 polytropic compression. So what is the relation between temperature and pressure? T2 upon T1 is equal to P2 upon P1 raised to N minus 1 upon N. Instead of gamma, we have to use N. So T2 is equal to T2 upon T1 is equal to P2 upon P1 raised to N minus 1 upon N. Now we have to calculate T2, P2, it is, P2 value is 650 kilopascal and P1 value is 100 kilopascal. So we'll write the values now. So P2 is 650 divided by P1 is 100 raised to, now be careful for the index, okay. So process 1 to 2 is which process? Polytropic process. And index N for process 1 to 2, it is 1.2. So index is 1.2. So here it will be 1.2 minus 1 upon 1.2 multiplied by T1. And T1 we have written 263. So from here we are getting this T2 value. So T2 comes out to be 359.29 Kelvin. You should remember that when you are using this polytropic or isentropic formula, the temperature should be in Kelvin only. And pressure unit should be either kilopascal or pascal. Or bar is also possible because it is, here you can see it is ratio. Next temperature is T4. So consider, we'll consider polytropic expansion now. So polytropic expansion 3 to 4. So process 3 to 4. Is polytropic expansion. And index N is given as 1.35. So we'll write down the relation between temperature and pressure. So T4 upon T3 is equal to P4 upon P3 raised to N minus 1 upon N. Now we have to calculate T4. So T4 is equal to T3, it is given in the question. T3 value is 303 Kelvin. So 303 multiplied by P4 value. Now this, here you can see the pressure ratio. Okay, P2 will be equal to P3 and P1 will be equal to P4. So P3, instead of P3 by, we have the ratio P4 by P3. So we can write P1 by P2 values over there. So P1 is 100. Okay, so 100 by 650 raised to 1.35 minus 1 upon 1.35. So from here we'll get T4 as 186.5 Kelvin. Next question we will see. So what we have to calculate? First is we have to find COP. Now we cannot directly use the COP formula which we had derived in terms of pressure ratio, because this is not a standard Bell-Coleman cycle. We have polytropic processes involved over here. So we have to go write the basic formula of COP. So first calculation is COP, and COP will be equal to Q dot A upon W dot net. Now this W dot net is equal to W dot C minus W dot E. So we'll write down the formula Q dot A. So formula will be heat absorbed during which process constant pressure. So here you can see constant pressure process 421. So this is Q dot A. So it will be, so heat is absorbed means final temperature 1 will be greater and T4 will be smaller. This you can understand from TH diagram. So if you want, you can draw TH diagram for the reference. So we have to just write, since this is constant pressure process, we have to write m dot Cp into delta T, and delta T will be higher temperature minus lower temperature. So after absorbing the heat, 1 will be higher and 4 will be, 4 is before absorption, absorbing heat. So 4 will be lower temperature. So write down. So Q dot A will be m dot A Cpa, higher temperature is T1 and lower temperature is T4, divided by. Now compression work here, it is polytropic. So we had derived one formula for polytropic work or power. So it was N upon N minus 1 m dot A R, higher temperature minus lower temperature, minus second process is also polytropic. Okay, so compression is also polytropic, which we have written over here. Temperature we will see from the diagram. And next one which we are writing is expansion. So again, expansion is also, this expansion is also polytropic. So we will write same formula, N upon N minus 1 m dot A R into temperature difference. Now this temperature difference we will get again from which diagram? TH diagram. Now compression, this compression, it is from process 1 to 2, and after compression temperature increases. So here the temperature difference will be T2 minus T1, higher temperature minus lower temperature. Next one is expander. And in case of expansion, what is the process number? Here we will see it is expansion is from process 3 to 4. And after the expansion process, temperature drops. So which temperature will be higher temperature? T3 will be higher. And then temperature drops, so T4 will be lower. So difference will be T3 minus T4. Now substitute all the values, we have all the values, right? M mass into m dot A will get cancelled. So m dot A, it will get cancelled. So here we can substitute the values. Here you have to assume Cp value If it is not given in question, you have to assume CP value. We'll check whether it is given in the question or not. So it is not given CP value. So we'll consider CP as 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin for air. And R is equal to 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin for air. So just you have to substitute the value CPA value you can substitute from here, R value you can substitute from here, all the temperatures we have calculated, T1, then T2, then T3 and T4 also we have calculated. Substitute all the values. You have to make sure that you are substituting proper value of N. So in this case, compression case, what is value of N? N in case of compression, it is 1.2. And N in case of expansion, it is 1.35. So substitute all the values, you will able to calculate COP. So COP of this system is 2.086. Now we'll see what is the next question. So second question is what? A critical question. Quantity of air circulated per minute. So we have to calculate what? M dot A. And unit will be kg per minute. For producing 2000 kg of ice per day at 0 degree Celsius from water at 20 degree Celsius. So water is given at 20 degree Celsius. Water will reject sensible heat. So we'll draw the diagram of that second part. So in order to calculate second part, we'll draw a diagram. So water is there, which is at 20 degree Celsius. So when latent heat is removed from water, latent heat is removed, finally the temperature of water will fall to 0 degree Celsius. So water will be at 0 degree Celsius. Now this water we have to convert it into ice. So we have to, first we have taken out sensible heat. So here this part will be sensible heat. And what is value of sensible heat? It will be m dot w, mass of water, into Cp of water into higher temperature minus lower temperature. Now mass of water, it is given in question. What is the mass of water given? It is 2000 kg. So just substitute that value. Mass of water is 2000 kg multiplied by Cp for water. It is 4.187 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. If it is not given, you have to assume. And higher temperature is 20 minus lower temperature is 0. So this will be sensible heat part. Next we will see finally what is given in the question. What is given? 2000 kg of water, which is at 20 degree Celsius, is converted into ice, and ice temperature is 0 degree Celsius. And per day is given. So time is also given over here. So what is the ice temperature? It is 0 degree Celsius. So next will be ice, and the temperature of ice is 0 degree Celsius. Now to convert water to ice, water and ice have same temperature, we have to extract latent heat. So this part will be latent heat. Now, how to calculate latent heat? This we have seen in previous numerical as well. So, latent heat is calculated by mass into HFG. Okay, and HFG is what? Latent heat. So, mass of water or ice into latent heat. Now, from this diagram, we are able to calculate what is the total heat that needs to be removed. So, what is the total heat that needs to be removed? It will be this sensible heat and this part is latent heat. So, we'll add both the terms. So, this will be equal to 2000 multiplied by 4.187 into 20 minus 0. And next heat, which is latent heat, is plus 2000. And I had told you to remember this value. Latent heat of ice is 335 kilojoule per kg. So, this value will be 335. So, from here, we'll get here. One more thing I'll like to mention is this is not m dot. Okay, so this is only m part. Here also, this part will be only m. So, from here we can calculate what is the total heat that needs to be removed from water, which is at 20 degree Celsius, to convert it to ice at 0 degree Celsius in one day. So, first we will calculate the heat which has to be removed, which is 837.48 into 10 raised to 3 kilojoule. Now, what we have to do is we have to calculate what is the rate. Okay, so rate will be what? Q dot A. Rate at which heat has to be removed. So Q dot A will be 837.48 into 10 raised to 3. This is the total heat which we have to remove. And what is the time given there? One day. So one day means it will be 24 hours. Convert hours into minutes. So multiply by 60. Again multiply by 60 to convert in seconds. So from here you will get Q dot A. So Q dot A comes out to be 9.693 kilojoule per second. Now what is this meaning of this Q dot A? What we have basically calculated is, we'll see that on this diagram, PV diagram. So basically 2000 kg of water is given and water temperature is 20 degree Celsius. So from that water we need to extract heat. So here you can see Q dot A is written. So this is the amount of heat which we calculated, which has to be extracted from water, which is at 20 degree Celsius, to convert it in ice at 0 degree Celsius in 24 hours. So this Q dot A value we have calculated. Now from here, what we have to calculate? Quantity of air circulated per minute, which is M dot A. This Q dot A, it is from 4 to 1, in which it is absorbing heat from water. So for air, which temperature will be higher one? It will be temperature T1. Why? Because here at 0.4 temperature, air is cool. And then that air takes heat from that water, 2000 kg. And it gets, so the temperature of air increases at 0.1. So temperature difference will be T1 minus T4. So we'll write down the QA formula now. So Q dot A is equal to, so we are calculating mass. So this one will be calculation of M dot A. So Q dot A will be what? M dot A Cp of air into higher temperature is T1 and lower temperature is T4. So Q dot A value is 9.693. M dot A we have to calculate. And Cp for air is 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. T1 value it is given in the question. So T1 value is 263 Kelvin and T4 value is 186.5 Kelvin. So 186.5 Kelvin and T1 value is 263. So from here we can calculate M dot A. So M dot A comes out to be 0.126 kg per second, and it has been asked what is the unit which has been asked, kg per minute. So convert that in kg per minute, multiply by 60. So finally M dot A is equal to 7.564 kg per minute. This is answer number 2. Next question is capacity of plant in TR, tons of refrigeration. So how to calculate capacity? We have to consider Q dot A to calculate capacity. So we'll calculate the third part now. So third part, capacity. So how to calculate capacity? Q dot A is equal to 3.5 into capacity. And Q dot A value we have just now calculated. Remember to substitute that value in kilojoule per second. Okay, so 9.693. So 9.693. So from here you can get value of capacity, and capacity is 2.769 TR. So what is meaning of this? What is meaning of this? In order to convert 2000 kg of water, which is at 20 degree Celsius, to ice at 0 degree Celsius in one day, how much tons of refrigeration is required? 2.769 TR.